Using dynamic type in SwiftUI is essential for any modern iOS app because it ensures accessibility and enhances user experience by allowing text to adapt to the user's preferred reading size. This feature supports inclusivity, catering to users with visual impairments or those who prefer larger text for readability. By implementing dynamic type, developers can create applications that are not only visually appealing, but also universally usable. This video will detail all the use cases demonstrating how to seamlessly integrate dynamic type into your SwiftUI projects, ultimately elevating the quality and accessibility of your app. Did you know that you can hire me? Go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/hireus, where you can submit your proposal and I could be working on your dream app. Now, today we are going to talk about dynamic type. So, what I have done is created a new Xcode project. And would you know it, this is a vanilla Xcode project. It's brand new. I haven't changed anything to the template. Now, what is this dynamic type? Why do we need it? Well, if you take a look at this button right over here and click on it and select dynamic type variants, you will actually get all of the dynamic type variants that an iPhone user might have and might select at any given moment. So let me just make this a little bit larger and disregard the code. I will give it back when we are going to type some code. So as you can see, there are a number of these dynamic type sizes. And the default one, by the way, it is large, and then it goes down to medium, small, and extra small, or it goes up to extra large, extra extra large, and extra 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 large. And then we have accessibility AX1 all the way up to AX5. Now remember, these can be chosen from the iPhone users settings app, and maybe they just chose AX5. And your app would still need to be workable delightful to look at. And today I'm going to show you how you can manage all of these. As you can see, let me just take a look at the extra small text. We can barely read it in this context. It's a really small iPhone device preview over there. And here it's extra, extra large. Of course, also the SF symbol, which by the way, it is a font too, so it behaves kind of the text as well. Okay, let me just move this back, kind of like this, and let me just disable this for now. And we have this hello world text. And we are going to talk about a few of these best practices for handling dynamic type. And we are going to use just this simple text. And the first tip is to just use the built-in font presets, not sizes. We're going to talk about sizes too, but first let's talk about the presets. Small business owners should have an app on the App Store to cater to their customers because it provides a direct, convenient, and engaging way to interact with their audience. An app can enhance customer loyalty through personalized experiences, offer easy access to services or products, and enable push notifications for promotions and updates. At rebeloper.com/hireus, I specialize in building tailored apps that meet the unique needs of small businesses. My expertise ensures a seamless development process, resulting in a high-quality app that helps your business thrive in today's digital landscape. Here we have Hello World. It is of font. And as you can see, if we just type out the font view modifier, it automatically adds the title, which makes this Hello World text a little bit larger than the previous one. But there is also a body. Now, the body type is basically the default type. If I remove this one, as you can see, nothing really changed. Let me just move this all the way up here and have it named body. There we go, body. Now, as you already saw, there are a few more. So let's just have this group over here. where I'm just going to go through all of them. So we have this group, and inside we have this body. So let's just go from kind of the largest one to all the way to the smallest one. I'm going to talk about each and every one of them, because some of them are not available in particular versions of iOS / SwiftUI. So what I'm going to do is just start off with the largest one, and that is large title. And that is large title. As you can see, this is the large title. You just, it's a large title. Now, let's just take a look at how the large title looks like on the different dynamic type variants. So you can see that it's actually, okay, it's a large title, but it's of different size on the different dynamic type selected by the user. As you can see, this is the one on the large one by default. And then here we have it on AX5. So remember, whenever the user chooses their specific dynamic type, the font, if you select the preset ones, will adjust accordingly. Let me just move this back to large title. Okay, so let's duplicate this. I'm just on the line that I want to duplicate and hit Command D. Next, we have the title. Of course, this is just a little bit smaller, so let's name this title. And as of iOS 14, SwiftUI has two new title types. Let me just duplicate this twice, title 2 and title 3. So let's name this title 2 and 3. As you can see, they're a little bit smaller as the original title. And this title, maybe it's a little bit bolder also. By the way, free right over here, so you can see it's actually smaller. Title free is a little bit smaller. Next up comes headline. Now, headline is a little bit interesting. Headline. So, okay, headline. It looks a little bit smaller than the title, of course, and it is bold. But let's take a look at it again in the dynamic type variant. And you will see a little bit of interesting things going on right over here. So as you can see, it's getting smaller and smaller. But as we go all the way up, it's not actually that small. As you can see, it's kind of like the title, two, title, three, headline. So it's a prominent thing that you want to address on your UI as the text. So yeah, bear in mind that the headline is a little bit different. It's not just scaling all the way down to the smallest size of the font. Okay, then there's a body. So, subheadline first. So, subheadline. Let's make this subheadline. The same structure, of course, applies what I talked about the headline. And there is then there is the body. So, body. This is the default one. If you don't choose anything for the font type, then you are just going to be using the body. And then there are the smaller ones from the body. First one, let's talk about the callout. As you can see, it's a little bit smaller. And then there is footnote. Well, callout, let me just name this callout. And then footnote. And yeah, usually you want to use all of these as they are named. You want to put it as a footnote. And finally, we have, let's duplicate this, the caption. I really like caption. It's a really a small font size that can be used in a variety of places. Usually I add a bold to it, but of course this is of taste. And as of iOS 14, again, they added a new version of the caption, caption 2, and that's a little bit smaller than the original caption. Okay, so these are the predefined font types, large title, title, 2 and 3, headline, subheadline, body, callout, footnote, caption, and caption 2. As you can see, they are on the big screen over here. Feel free to take a look at them on the dynamic type variants over here. Okay, so this is one good practice to follow. Just use the built-in font types. But sometimes this is not enough. Maybe you want a larger title. Maybe you want an even smaller caption for your font size. For that, you are going to use a font of system size. And I'm not going to talk about the weight and all of that, like setting bold or italic. We're not interested in this tutorial about that. But you can certainly change those too. So let me just comment this out so we are not going to have a lot of clutter in the UI. And let's create another group. And let's have a text. So this is the body kind of size, the default one. Let's set a preset one. So that can be done with the system. And we are going to use the size. And let's go for 24 right over there. So there it is. Hello, dynamic type. As you can see, it's different from the default body one. But what happens if I enable the dynamic type variants right over there? Let's just see. Let me make this a little bit larger. And as you can see, because we added a custom constant font, 24, right over here, it's the same size on all of the variants, which is basically not that good at all, because users expect all of these variants to adhere to their presets. So what to do right over here? Because I really actually do want to use this size on the large variant. So for that, there's a really, really cool thing that you can use, and that is called the scaled metric property wrapper. So we are going to use the scaled metric, at scaled metric, private, var, and I'm just going to name it here size, and it will be a CG float. And let's set its default value to, its value to 24. So now I'm going to just simply copy and paste the same thing. As you can see, nothing really changed. I don't know if you squint a little bit, you see that they are the same size. I'm going to make it larger in just a second. So now what I'm going to do is grab this scaled metric and put it as the size on the second text right over there. And now you can see the changes. As you can probably noticed, now on the large one, it's the same, because the default value is the large for the variant. And then on the medium, it gets smaller, smaller on the small, even smaller on the extra small. So it adapts, and it gets even larger on extra large and all of that stuff. Although on the accessibilities too. So on the AX5, as you can see, it takes up all three lines right over there. So this is what you should be using. Never ever go for a constant value for the system size. Create a scaled metric of a CG float, set your size, and then the system will handle it for you. Now, I am always using scaled metric in the apps that I've built for my customers. And if you are interested in me building you your app idea, your dream app, maybe you're a business and you want an app for your customers, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/hireus. The link is down in the description.